A statement from the United Kingdom regarding the leak of Kate Middleton's medical files from the London Clinic has sparked a veritable tempest of events. Yesterday, we witnessed the debate of two narratives. One suggests that a member of the clinic's staff merely rummaged through the medical archives of the Princess of Wales. Meanwhile, international media outlets have accused Russia and its hackers of illicitly accessing data from the London Clinic. The matter even reached Gunning Street, and the government faced a crisis, with a united front being drawn among all political parties, demanding solidarity with Kate Middleton in light of these events. Should this leak have been intentional, it must be emphasized that it constitutes a legal violation. No nation that is a member of the United Nations has the right to disclose such information without facing subsequent punishment or legal prosecution. Now, the question is whether these details will be published or leak through a country not entirely involved in the process. Given recent claims about Russian hackers, the situation appears quite unsettling. To date, the British government has not commented on this issue, which is surprising. Yesterday, in a video where Trump criticized British reality shows, this very topic was discussed. It was evident that the British Prime Minister diplomatically and politely commented on the health of Charles II, but no more, unlike the former US president, who, incidentally, made some statements. Our audience is not limited to Spain and Latin America, but now with these events, it has expanded to the USA, Canada, and other European countries. We have not engaged in politics before, but now we are compelled to comment. It is surprising that the former president has become so actively involved in this, considering his usual non-confrontational stance. However, it's one thing when I decide that the editorial policy of this channel should not include political issues. A few hours ago, official sources on Downing Street called on Britons to support the Princess of Wales in light of numerous conspiracy theories and, particularly, in light of the incident with her medical data. There are very strict patient confidentiality rules that must be observed. I insist that no media outlet in the world will publish this because they would face tremendous problems in court, likely leading not only to substantial compensation, but also to imprisonment for those responsible. There are also several unknown factors in this matter. It is said that the breach occurred after she was discharged from the hospital, but the medical institution has not specified whether the violation happened before or after this. This is a question that causes much agitation, especially considering all the controversy and Kate being at the center of attention. Well, someone clearly took advantage of this situation to make it public. Perhaps there is a grain of truth in one of those conspiracy theories that suddenly emerged, saying, "It's written in the medical dossier," and building their assumptions on that. I am confident that Scotland Yard is working on this. Likely, NI5 is involved, or perhaps even NI6, which deals with matters outside the United Kingdom. Interestingly, the Daily Mirror, which remains a British tabloid, claimed that they did not have access to King Charles II's medical data.